Hi, I'm Susan Timmons, Upper School Instructional Librarian at Harpeth Hall. This video will show you how to conduct a reverse image search, either by using your Google Chrome browser, uploading an image directly, or using TinEye. When you suspect a website is giving you faulty information, for example, that Christopher Columbus was born in the year 1951, you shouldn't trust pictures you find on that website any more than you should trust any other kind of information. For example, this picture that's labeled Christopher Columbus is already suspicious because it's not giving us much more information. We don't know when this illustration was created. We don't know the name of the author. There are some words up here in the corner, but we can't quite read them. So before we use this as a picture of Christopher Columbus, we need to do a little more research. If you're already in Google Chrome as your browser, you can actually just right-click on an image and launch a Google image search right there. What it's going to do is search Google for any other websites that are using that same image. It'll bring you some image results. And for example, you can click on all sizes and actually see the images that it has gone out and found. But a lot of them are from All About Explorers or similar sites that you've already looked at. And I suspect that's because this image size has the caption right inside it. And so that might be throwing off the search. So there's another tool you can use. If you go down to Windows and you type in Snip, you can launch the Snip and Sketch tool and just click New Snip. What you'll be able to do is take a snip of just the artwork and leave off the label or anything else. Go ahead and click Save and save and name this as a JPEG file somewhere on your desktop. And then you can go into Google and actually click up in the top right hand corner Images to start your own image search. If you click on Search by Image, that's this little camera icon right here. You can either paste in a URL, or in our case, you're going to upload the file that you just created. So you're going to navigate to the JPEG file that you just snipped, and now it's going to search with that file. Now, if you scroll down, you can see it trying to think of what this image might be, and sure enough, it has a suggestion. And this picture seems an awful lot like the one that we have. And this is an illustration of someone named Thomas Hobson, not Christopher Columbus. So let's do a quick Google search and see who Thomas Hobson is and look at some other images of Thomas Hobson. And let's see if we can find where this image came from. If I do just a regular Google keyword search with my search terms and I click on images, I can see the other images described as illustration of Thomas Hobson, and I can see what websites they're in. So for example, this is in the National Portrait Gallery from the United Kingdom, and here's the British Museum. So if I explore there, I can locate this image and actually confirm who created it, what year it was created, and know that I should not use it as an image of Christopher Columbus because it is most definitely an image of Thomas Hobson. And now it sort of makes sense. The text that I couldn't read before in the corner, it says Hobson. It even says the year 1630, which is probably the year the print was made. And I can definitely use this image if I need an illustration of Thomas Hobson. But if I want an image of Christopher Columbus, I need to find a more reliable website before I can trust that image. And just keep in mind, if Google image search is ever not working for you, there's always another website you could try. TinEye.com does the exact same thing. You can paste in a URL or upload your image, and you can get image results from TinEye.com. So happy searching.